pitch in, and we're just about set to kick off. And now it's time for the coin toss, and it's brought to you by Coke Zero. Real Coca-Cola taste, zero calories. Enjoy everything. Idaho has been waiting all week for this one. Get ready, folks. The opening kickoff is finally here. He's to the 20. He's tackled at the 28. Fresno State staff and their fans have heard all week long their quarterback's going to play terribly on the road. I think their staff's got them ready to prove them wrong right now.
I think this staff really has rallied this entire team around some of that negative talk. And I think they believe in their guy that he can go on the road and make the plays and lead them to a big victory. You know, sometimes when you hit some adversity like that, you see teams circle the wagons. And I really believe this week they've done a great job of doing that. Now they just have to go out and execute the plan and go out and win this game.
They come out in a 5-wide set. Got the corner. Nice catch on that one. Brought down at the 40-yard line.
It's a great job here by the quarterback of recognizing the outside linebacker blitz and delivering the football for a first down.
And a quick throw. And he's taken down around the 35-yard line.
Well, the defense brought a lot of pressure, and that time they got burned. If you don't get to this quarterback on the blitz, you're giving him a ton of room to make a play.
Complete. He's got room. He goes out of bounds around the 30-yard line. Got an opening. He's at the 20. Tackle at the 11. There to get in the backfield and bring him down.
And once he gets moving, there's no stopping him. This guy is so big and strong that he's almost impossible to block with one guy.
It's second and 12. Ball on the 13-yard line. Gets to about the 11-yard line. Quick throw, and he's stopped behind the line, and they lose a couple there.
They really just didn't have any room to work on that play. The defense just suffocated them there.
It's fourth down. They'll line it up for the field goal. Fresno State is looking to go up by three. Kicks away, and it's good. The Bulldogs saw one of their top players going down earlier, but it looks like he's going to be able to get back in there. Nice kick, plenty of distance. He's to the 20. They'll bring him down at the 23. So let's see what the offense can do as they come out onto the field. He's brought down in the open field.
I'll tell you something, I'm loving this quarterback's confidence more and more as this game goes on. He's really throwing the ball with some purpose.
We've got a first and 10. Ball on the 35. And they've got all their DBs in there to match up against the 5-wide set. He's got it with room to run.
That was a really nice play on the ball by the receiver for a substantial gain and a first down.
Run up the gut.
That's good for a gain of 4 yards. That'll make it second and seven.
Second down, 7 yards to go. Ball on the 49. They go with the run, and he's taken down behind the line.
That was a loss of 2 yards. That'll bring up third and 8.
tight end, but it falls to the ground.
That's a miscommunication between a quarterback and a wide receiver right there. They need to get their signal straight.
He fields the punt at the 13. Tackle made at the 26.
So we're just about ready to return to action.
Fresno State holds a field goal lead. And they make the stop right around the 26-yard line. To the 40, and they push him out at the 43.
That was a nicely thrown ball with some arc on it. He's a very precise passer, and he makes it look easier than it is.
They come out on an empty backfield. He scrambled. He's tackled at about the 45. He made a real nice play on that one.
I'll tell you what, in today's game, you have to have the ability to run the football. Give the quarterback a lot of credit. He made a great play and really gave his team a boost.
Caught over the middle, and he's tackled right around the 40. Pickup of 5.
You don't have to go deep every play to be successful. They got 5 yards on the play, and that's always a good game.
There's a strike complete. They'll bring him down to the 37-yard line. So it's complete, but they didn't get much there.
And that's because the defense was just waiting on it, and they attacked. The quarterback should have found somebody else downfield.
And they get him in the backfield for a loss. And that run got stuck.
Yeah, you're right. The defense definitely won the battle at the line of scrimmage there.
He'll try to knock this punt down inside the 20. This one will go into the end zone, and they'll bring it out to the 20.
And while they are behind, they know they can knot things up in a heartbeat. It's way too early to change your game plan.
Complete. He's got space to work. And down he goes. Right around the 38-yard line.
It's first and 10. Ball on their own 38.
As a running back, you've got to get upfield north and south. That time, he just seemed to wait and kind of delay his reaction and just got to be able to make a read, get upfield as quickly as possible. In college football, and especially up in the NFL, the more you're dancing around waiting for a big play, the more time you're giving an athletic defense a chance to come and make a play in the backfield against you. And that's what happened.
First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 38-yard line.
He's under some heat. He wants it all. Spectacular play, and now it's first and goal.
Illegal touching. Offense. Still second down.
Both offenses trying to find their rhythm in that first quarter. Low scoring and close right now. 3-0, Fresno State. Set to resume action here in the second quarter, and we've got a tight ball game.
hands out to his receiver.
The ball pops free. The defense falls on it.
What do you think about that last turnover, Kirk?
Way to be heads up out there. That corner just made one heck of a play recovering that fumble.
In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions.
Fresno State is up by three. He gets it out to about the 47-yard line. They'll spread the field here. Let's see what the defense does with a five-wide outlook. Big opening. Tackle made at about the 41.
Here they come. He's scrambling. He's taken down at the 36.
That's good for a gain of 5 yards. That brings him second.
They'll spread the field with five wide. Quick release. Tight end. Incomplete.
In the passing game, the chemistry and the rhythm between a quarterback and his receivers are very important. Here he has an open tight end, and he just throws it to a wrong spot. Those guys got to get on the same page.
Fires right side. Got his tailback. Locked down. Right around the 30. Pitches it. He's got the corner. And he is drilled at the 24-yard line. Got a man in and out of his hands. And this play is number 8 on the drive.
Fresno State is up a field goal.
Makes the catch, and look out. Fumble, loose ball.
Man, that is a tough break for the offense. You connect with your wideout, hoping to make a play, and he winds up losing control of the ball. Man, that hurts.
There hasn't been too much daylight between these two teams. In games like this, some players try to press too much, and that can cause mistakes. Throws it in a hurry, and he's hit immediately. They're about 4 yards away here on second down. Caught, enough for the first down. And he's taken down right around the 32-yard line. And 10. Ball on the 44. He's got his man across the middle, and he hits him hard at the 46-yard line.
Like that, the worst thing you want to do is just to throw the ball into coverage. He got away with one right there. He's very fortunate. Next time, he should just throw it away out of bounds.
So it's second and 10. Ball on the 46-yard line.
Pulls it in. First down, and he's knocked out of bounds. Stop at the 16-yard line. And this is the eighth play of the drive. A huge play, and now they're in a great position to score.
How about the big fellas up front? This line will have to continue to play like that to build the consistency to help this offense be effective.
It's first down, and they'll be looking for 6 points here. He gets rid of this one. Here's play number 10 on the drive. Short burst for the score.
That's what happens when you can win the war in the trenches down near the goal line.
And he converts the extra point. A 10-play, 90-yard drive. And that's good for a touchdown.
Brett, I thought the key to that drive really had a lot to do with the quarterback and the receivers getting in sync, making it very tough for the defense to slow him down.
Idaho ready to kick this one off. He kicks it off, and he got all of that one. He's to the 20, and he's tackled at the 24.
I just love to watch this defense play. They've been flying all over the field today, making big play after big play. The crazy thing is, he still have such a close game despite how well they've played.
So can the defense match their effort from the last drive with another takeaway?
Anytime you give the ball away, it's a disappointment. So these guys want to show that they can hang on to it.
Delivers to the halfback on the screen. He's tackled at the 32-yard line.
Very solid gain through the air. I'm impressed with the poise of this quarterback and the ability of the receiver to keep his concentration and get his hands on the football.
Quick strike to the back, and he drops it.
That is textbook pass defense. As soon as the ball hit the receiver's hands, he was all over it.
It's third down, and they're about 2 yards shy of the sticks. He laterals the ball. Knocked out of bounds at about the 35. That makes it first and 10. They go with a screen here, and the halfback's got it. He gets hit out of bounds around the 44-yard line. That's a key. First down. First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 44. Sets up a screen. Tailback's got it. They'll drop him for a loss. They're stopped for a 5-yard loss.
This defense is fast enough that they can create negative yards on completed passes. So the offense might want to consider that next time they try that play.
Quick throw, and he tackles him hard at the 34.
Check three.
caught with room to work.
And he's tackled right around the 24-yard line.
Nice pickup as they connect on the pass play.
Well, they look to be in sync right now. They're both reading the defense properly, and the result is a nice game.
He's going to try and scramble. Dives for extra yardage. Bounces off a would-be tackler. Room around the corner. Throws for the touchdown, and it's going to be an interception.
The linebacker here does a good job with his instincts and getting in the pass to the receiver. Boy, what a great play.
First and 10. Ball on their own 9. Idaho is up 4. He's to the 20. He makes his way out to about the 25. We head into halftime with both offenses struggling. The Vandals lead it 7-3.
Glad to have you with us in the studio for the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 halftime show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Reese Davis and David Pollock here, completely locked in on that first half. The pass rush of both teams has been totally negated in the first half. Neither team has been able to come up with a sack. So what's the D-line coach right now preaching to you guys up front, you big fellas who love to go there and make life miserable for a quarterback?
Well, you got to watch the football and get off it as soon as you can and try to get that first step quickness, because I know those guys are big and strong, but they're also a little bit chunky. And if you're on the defensive line and you're a little bit slimmer and you get off the football a little bit faster, but try to get off that ball quick. And it's not just sacks, Reese. How about you affect the quarterback? How about you bull rush your guy and you put him in his lap and you make him throw over top, or, you know, change the throwing angle so he doesn't have a clean pocket where he can step up in there and make big throws the whole game. You got to do something different than you did the first half to affect the quarterback.
Just about set to start the second half. What are you looking for?
I'm looking to see which team has that decided schematical advantage.
And if they can find it, they'll blow holes 3 or 4 axe handles wide. Brad and Kirk will be there to call the second half.
Boy, I hope the second half's as good as the first. Just about set to start the third quarter in a tight one.
He'll take it from the 2. He gets out to about the 25-yard line.
Well, the guys are chomping at the bit down there, waiting for the game to start back up.
Idaho holds a 4-point lead.
A smartly run route, good protection, and a well-placed ball. Most times, you don't need much more than that.
From their own 38-yard line, it's first down. He steps out around the 40-yard line.
Gains his way to the 46-yard line.
We've got a first and 10. Ball on the 46. And down he goes at the 41-yard line. The 41-yard line. Third down. They keep it on the ground with the tailback. He's at the 30, makes it out to about the 26. Is up by 4. Quick throw to the tight end. He's knocked out of bounds at the 17-yard line. Here's the 8th play of the series. He tackles him for a loss. And here's another third down. And he's immediately tackled. This is the 10th play of the drive. Tackle made around the 3-yard line. So it's second down and about 2 yards to go. Open receiver, and it's incomplete. We're at the 12th play of the drive. Touchdown, Vandals.
It takes a lot of strength to run it when you're heading into a massive pile of bodies. Good job of holding on to it and getting it across the goal line.
And he hits the PAT. A 12-play, 75-yard drive. And the result, 7 points.
Brad, I thought that was a textbook drive. I thought they did a really good job of showing balance, mixing the play calling with the run and the pass. Just an overall well-executed touchdown drive.
So our score, 14-3. Idaho's the type of team, when you look at them, it looks like their defense sort of just feeds off itself.
I think the energy is there, Brad, but I think it really starts up front with their defensive line and their linebackers, the way they're being able to just win the battle at the line of scrimmage. I think it's giving them confidence, and it's allowing them to play more downhill where they can attack this offense.
And they get him in the backfield for a loss. Second down and 11 to go. Ball on the 24-yard line. Pulls it in, and he could score. He's to the 40, the 50. Inside the 30. He's taken down around the 19-yard line.
Now, that was a good-looking screen pass. The defense blitzed, and that played right into the hands of the screen. It's hard to stop a screen when you blitz the quarterback.
They're in the red zone, so this quarterback better be smart. Last time, he threw a pick down here. Throws a laser across the middle.
the five. Touchdown, Bulldogs. He makes the PAT. They line up to kick this one away. Nice kick, plenty of distance. He's to the 20. Man, both offenses here in this third quarter have been on fire. Time for the defense to step to the forefront a little bit.
Makes you wonder which of these defenses has the ability to come up and make a stop. It could be one of those games where whichever defense comes up with that stop could be the team that wins the game.
The quarterback did a really good job in the last drive of finding his receivers in space, and I bet he'll be looking to do the same thing again.
Idaho is up four. And he just gets rid of it. From their own 24-yard line, it's second down. He guns it. Stays in bounds and made a nice catch. From their own 46-yard line, first down. Brought down around the 43-yard line. Empty backfield, quarterback in the gun, five wide receivers. Quick throw, incomplete, one of his receivers. Third down, to get it inside the 44. Defensive coordinator anticipating this five wide set, and he comes in with his dime package. Quick throw out to the receiver, incomplete. Fielded at the 19. He makes it out to maybe the 29-yard line. This offense did really well with the air attack on their last trip out there. Let's see if they can do the same thing here.
Well, I think this defense has got to do something, because right now the quarterback is in such a good rhythm that you've got to do something to try to get him out of it. I would suggest trying to bring more pressure. Try to come up with an exotic blitz look to try to get him on his heels as opposed to being the aggressor and attacking the defense.
And he's taken down at the 30-yard line. A screen pass, gets it to the back. That pass play went for nearly enough to keep moving, but they're stopped just short. Boy, that's tough.
That is always a tough pill to swallow. Having to leave the field, knowing how close you came to converting on third down. You got to get those.
The punt upcoming, and they're going to come after this one.
Oh, what a hit.
Not great, but not bad either. As long as your main priorities are not turning the ball over and establishing solid field position, then you're headed in the right direction.
Their last drive ended in a punt, so this quarterback's going to be looking for something better on this drive.
Idaho
holds a four-point lead. And they make the stop at the 36. A couple, maybe 3 yards on that run.
That'll make it second and seven.
The fourth quarter is going to decide who wins this low-scoring affair. The Vandals lead it 14-10. Well, Welcome back to the action here as we resume play here in quarter number four. First and 10. Ball on their own 45. The defense has got some of their best pass defenders on the field. They set up in the dime to counter that five wide receiver set. And he throws it away. Away here on third down. Slings it, and they push him out around the 44-yard line.
Well, on third down, we expected them to go to the air, and they did just that, picking up the first down.
First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 22. Idaho is up by four. He might not be able to get the pass off. Fires quick to an open man. He dropped it. This is the eighth play of this drive.
That makes it second and 10.
He gets rid of this one. The defense got some pressure and forced a bad pass.
I think they've been a little bit more aggressive here with their pass rush, and that time it paid off with an incompletion.
And they'll look to convert here on another third down. He's going left. And this one falls incomplete. Kicks up, and it sails through the uprights. Looks like they're ready for the kick. He's to the 20. I'm sure the return man would have loved to go for six that time.
Well, this is what it's all about. You work all week. You get into a position to compete in a game. It comes down to the fourth quarter where you need a drive and you need a touchdown. Who can step up? I need to see a playmaker right here step up and make the play to give themselves a chance to score a touchdown.
He chucks it downfield.
Well, you want to do everything you can to keep the ball out of the hands of these receivers. So that was a really good effort.
From their own 34-yard line, second down. Get out of trouble, but he can't shake the defense. And he's going to come up with a sack. After the sack, it's now fourth and long.
The ball.
Just under three to go in regulation.
Yeah.
Made a few guys miss on his way to a quality return. You know this is a real crucial time in the game. It could still go either way. Pulls down the catch, and he's got room here. 4 yards on that play.
You don't have to throw it deep to have success. Any sort of completion can help boost an offense's confidence.
From the 40-yard line, second down. Brought down, nothing doing. They didn't have much of a chance on that play.
Boy, this defense has a lot of speed. They're all over him by the time he caught the ball.
They need about 3 yards to get the first down here on third down. And he's tackled at about the 29-yard line.
Here's the true test of a quarterback at any level. Can they make a good under pressure when one or two or three guys are coming right at him? I think this young passer has proven that, yes, he can.
He's hit and taken down. There's a strike complete. They got 4 yards on that one.
The play action throws the defense just long enough for the quarterback to get the ball to the receiver. Nice play.
Hands off left, and they got him behind the line. Third down, and they need to get it to the 19. They'll spread the field here. Let's see what the defense does with a five wide outlook. To double their lead here as they close in on the goal line. They're crowding that line of scrimmage. This play is number 8 on the drive. And this one comes to an end. Our final count in this game, 17-10, Vandal. That's going to do it for this presentation of NCAA Football 14. For Kirk Herbstreit, this is Brad Nessler saying goodbye.